I want to welcome you to our course on observation in Montessori. During the foundation lectures, we really stressed philosophy, the love of wisdom that is so profound within Dr. Montessori's practice with children in learning environments. Wisdom is based on observation. What do we mean by that? We mean a practicality. It's a very practical need that we have, which is to observe if we're going to have wisdom. I recall once upon a time, not too many years ago, I was working as a Montessorian in Colorado, and I was going through a personal crisis and I needed wisdom badly. And someone directed me to an Apache medicine woman for the first time in my life. I went to an Apache medicine woman. And her advice to me was to go up into the mountains alone and to walk off trail by myself and to see what the spirit, the great spirit, would reveal to me. I said, "That's it?" And she said, "That's it." And I was used to hiking on trail up in the mountains of Colorado. And here she had advised me to go off trail. So I went off trail. And I became apprehensive, first of all, because I was in the wilds. And I began to really take on the observation skills of a Native American. I had to look more keenly and listen more keenly and even smell more keenly, because I didn't want a bear to come out or a cougar come out on me unexpected, or a snake that I would step on. And I became so conscious that I was now using skills I had long not used at all, which was to observe where I was putting my feet, where I was walking, what was surrounding me. Observation for the Montessori educator is a very practical skill, because we're not really involved in a method. We're involved with a response to the needs of the child. And we can't know that unless we observe. I'm reminded of that wonderful lyric that George Harrison sings, "I really want to see you, Lord. I really want to know you. I really want to follow you. I really want to show you." And that's primarily the role that we have with the child. We can't know the child truly unless we follow the child. Montessori advises us that we must follow the child. What does that mean, to follow the child? We want to get into that deeply as we go along. But the whole purpose, the practical purpose of following the child, observing the child, is so that we can know the child, discover the child, as Montessori advises us to do. We have to discover the child. To help us do that, during these lectures on observation, we'll be touching upon the specifics of what's called by Montessori scientific observation. Sounds kind of spooky, scientific observation. Keep in mind that the word science simply means to know. It's an observation that's purposed to help us to know, as I said, to discover the reality of this child or this child or this child or this child at this moment and this next moment. We're going to be studying through the course of these lectures the works of Maria Montessori, the words of Maria Montessori, the suggestions of Maria Montessori, and of William James, who was her colleague, so to speak, in the United States of America. Both were medical doctors who became fathers of psychology in their own countries. Dr. Montessori was the mother of psychology in Europe and science in Italy, and William James was the father of psychology in America. We're going to touch upon those two great minds, as well as Vygotsky. And then we're going to look at the craft as practiced by the eminent psychologists Erik Erikson and Brunel Bettelheim and Karen Horney. Psychology is important for us, and psychology certainly is one of the sciences of observation of the human reality before us. We're going to take up the skills of reflective listening as described by Carl Rogers, the great American psychologist. It's important for us to be able to develop this rare skill of reflective listening because the child so often speaks to us in many ways, including nonverbal ways. So our observation is going to not only be with our eyes, but also with our ears and with our own sense of what it is to be human. We're going to try to observe, and we'll talk about what you need to do when you want to specifically observe the critical important influences of the Montessori learning environment, the Montessori educator herself or himself, and then also the very presences of the individual children that are before us. At the very end of our lectures, we're going to touch upon the recent work of a great American psychologist who came from Hungary, whose name is Csikszentmihalyi. And he's very important for us because he's a very positive psychologist. He wants us to observe the positive, and especially the process, the flow that's within the development of a child. And he's also a very positive psychologist, and he helps us to see the joy that is should be there always within children as well as all human beings. Throughout the course, you're going to be asked to reflect on the principles being expounded in these videos, to write your summaries of your observation of actual learning environments and the individual lessons that you might see being presented. We'd like you to respond to certain basic questions and also to participate in periodic chat rooms, discussions of important craft that we're trying to develop, this craft of observation. It's very important for you to, and I want to advise you very, very much so, to spend time observing these videos that we have for your observation. There'll be actually tapes of children at work within a Montessori learning environment. And spend time with it. Spend at least 15 to 20 minutes observing, getting in the habit of observation. It's not something that you're used to. Don't pull away from it too soon. We want you to refer to the syllabus of the weekly schedule of the course. It's important to keep up with your cohorts who are also taking the course, so don't fall behind, especially in the discussion sections. If you fall behind, it's going to inhibit your ability to learn from others and their ability to learn from you. So use your syllabus to organize your time throughout the course that's coming up now. There is a required text and it's listed at the bottom of your syllabus. Please try to acquire one as soon as you can to make use of it. I'd like to end this introduction by quoting something from Montessori about observation. It comes from her wonderful book called Spontaneous Activity in Education. She writes, "The fundamental quality of the Montessori educator is the capacity for observation, a quality so important that the positive sciences were also called sciences of observation." Now, it's obvious that the possession of senses and of knowledge is not sufficient to enable a person to observe. It's just not enough that we have the senses that we observe with, she says. It is a habit which must be developed by practice. And that's why, though listening to the videos is very important, you have to begin developing a strong habit of observation by practicing it. So I want to urge you to begin to do that wherever you are. And particularly begin doing it now in this course on observation with the observational videos that we provide you. I hope you will enjoy it, and I look forward to reading and responding to your discussions and your observations.